Hello my dear students, today I will be teaching you chapter 3, that is formatting documents. Okay, so let's get started. First of all, what I need to do is I need to open my Microsoft Word. Clear? Open Microsoft Word. What is Microsoft Word? A software. What type of software? Word processing software. Okay, it is a word processing software. What is document? Document is whatever text you are typing and saving it using word processor, any kind of word processor, it typically becomes a document. Is that clear? Okay, moving forward. Whatever fundamental, starting from the beginning to pro, everything I will explain to you via this practical demonstration. Okay, now for the very first thing, what I need to do is I need to type something. Okay, let's randomly type something. Again pressing enter, the line changes. Do not forget, by pressing enter, line changes. Again I will show you. See, I am keeping on writing. As soon as I will press enter, the line will change. See, check out. Okay, writing. Whatever things you want to write, keep on writing. Press enter, line gets changed. Okay, see, now to delete all this, what you can do is you can press the backspace key. Understood? I suppose that you do know what is a backspace key. You can press backspace key. See, things are getting deleted. Or else you can use the delete key also, but note that the delete key, to delete using delete key, you need to click before the text. Understood? Whatever text you want to delete, you need to click and take the cursor before the text. See, let's suppose this is the text what I need to delete, then I need to make the cursor in front of this text, before the text, that is over here, and then press delete. See, the whole text is getting deleted. Okay, this is the difference. And in case of backspace key, I will click the cursor just after the text. See, backspace is pushing the text and deleting it. Do you know what is pushing and pulling? See, backspace pushes the text and keeps deleting, but in case of delete key, it pulls the text. See, it's pulling itself, it's pulling the text. Is that clear? Okay, this was the very beginning thing, very fundamental thing, deleting and all those things. Now let's suppose I need to change the format of this whole thing. What I need to do is I need to select first. So how am I supposed to select? Click at the very beginning. Is that clear? Click at the very beginning and do not leave the left click of the mouse. Okay, and then drag the whole thing. Keep dragging. Done. Okay, after that, leave. Again, I will explain. Left click on the very beginning. Do not leave the left click button and then start dragging it. slowly, do not leave the left click. Clear? Start dragging. See, it's done. Okay, after that, leave it, leave the left click. See, now since the text you want to select is selected, you can do various changes. Let's suppose you want to make the whole text as bold. You can click on this B, alphabetical B. As soon as you will click upon this alphabetical B, it will become bold. Bold. How? By using this alphabetical B. If you want to change this and change it to italics, you can do using this, pressing this I. See, it became italics. Isn't it? Select and press on U. See, the whole text got underlined. So this is the way. If you want to remove the bold part, again press on alphabetical B. See, it became normal. if you want to remove the italics part, again click on I, it became normal. If you want to remove the underlined part, see, it became underlined part is removed. Okay, now one more very important thing is, let's suppose you want to change the color of your text. What will you do? First of all, select the whole thing, go over here, this alphabetical A, after that a triangular sign is present, click upon that. Various colors are available, you can click upon any of the color. Let's suppose this red color, the color got changed, right? Similarly, let's suppose you want to change the background color, then what you need to do is, this bucket changes the background color. See, is that clear? Now let's suppose this very specific line you want to make some other color, change it to some other color, that is also possible. See, okay, now let's suppose you want to format the paragraph, okay, so that is also possible. See, if you will click upon this, the paragraph will change to center alignment. If you will click upon this, the paragraph will change upon to right alignment. Understood? And if you will click upon this, your paragraph will change to justified. Clear? So these four options are there. These four, I think you are able to visualize, right? These four options are there to change the alignment. Is that clear? Do not forget to select. Do not forget to select first. Understood? Let's suppose you want to change the alignment to right, click upon this. You want to change the alignment to center, click upon this. You want to change the alignment to left, click upon this. And if you want to change the alignment to right, click upon this. Clear? Shortcut keys are also there. Let's suppose you want to change the alignment to left alignment, press the control button, do not leave the control button, and press alphabetical L from your keyboard. See, changed, right? Similarly, if you want to change it to right alignment, press the control button, do not leave it, and then press the alphabetical R. Changed. See, so in this way you can change the alignment. Understood? Now let's suppose you want to change the line spacing, the amount of space between the two individual lines. Understood? That is also possible. First of all, select the text. Clear? After that, come over here. See, line spacing. If I will press on one, see, the spacing between two individual line became small, right? Similarly, first of all, select the whole thing. After that, click upon here. Let's suppose 3. See, the amount of space between two individual line increased, isn't it? So this is how we increase the cell spacing. Okay, now let's suppose you have completed the text editing. Okay, all these features comes under editing the text. Understood? Editing, modification, these are same thing. Okay, now if you want to print this thing using your printer, what will you do? The very easiest part is, press the control button, do not leave it, and then press upon alphabetical P. See, print option came. Understood? Now, let's suppose my printer name is Microsoft XPS. You can have different printers. You can visualize from here. Understood. Mine is Microsoft XPS Document Writer. Okay. So now, though it is not an actual printer, understood, it is just a method of saving the file. Understood. Now, let's suppose you want how many copies? Let's suppose this same thing, this same text, this same page, you want 10 copies. You can increase the number of copies from here. See, 10 copies. As soon as you will click on OK, 10 pages will print with same content. The same page will print 10 times. Is that clear? Let's suppose I have various pages. I have many pages. Let's suppose this is the first page. See, this one is the second page. And in second page also I have written something. And now I need to print this. What will you do? Press the control button and then do not leave the control button and press P. Print option came. Let's suppose you want both the pages. Then leave this all as ticked. Understood. Leave this as this only, same only. Understood. Let's suppose if you want only the first page, that means this page, to be printed, what you do is click on pages, page number 1. Understood. And then click on OK. That means this first page will get printed. Okay. Not this second page. Okay. Now click on OK. This first page will get printed. If you want this page to be printed, this is the second page. Type 2 and then press OK. This first page will not get printed. Instead, the second page will get printed. Okay. So this is the way. Now at the end, let's suppose you want to save this whole thing. You want to save the document. How will you do? Control S. Clear? Control S. That means, again I will tell you, press the control button, do not leave it. After that, press the S, alphabetical S. Something like this will appear. You need to give a name. Let's suppose I am giving the document name as Amarnath. Okay. And destination will be desktop. So this document will save as amarnath.doc where on desktop. Save. Clear? Another method is you can click over here also. Save option is here. See. Click on here. It will get saved. Is that clear? Okay. Thank you, students.